Well, I think it was mostly mental. I mean, certainly the wind plays a factor in the ball that gets sent back. And we, you know, we talked about not playing to the goalkeeper unless absolutely necessary, but you know, then it happens and we lose our focus and we're down 1-0, and that's the difference in the game.
A little bit. Usually it's not quite this windy yet, but like any other day, we have to be prepared for whatever the elements and whatever Mother Earth gives us. For me personally, it came down to mentality for the first half of me being able to weather this first whole 45, not just the 15 like we always talk about. I did all right with that. Had my big major slip up and jeopardized the game. I thought the ball was coming at a decent pace. I misjudged the runner. I thought she was a little further out, so I was able to maybe take a touch and clear it with my feet, but then she picked off my touch and put it in the...
Yeah, she played very well, but I think, again, the quality of our attack, the quality of the final ball, the final decision is really lacking right now. Our girls are capable of doing it, but we've got some work ahead of us. Yes, I am. I mean, I think that we've got some fantastic dynamic attackers, and the fact that we haven't scored a goal is rather disappointing, but we've got to keep the big picture. Yes, Nevada, Montana, back-to-back days, something we haven't done in a long time. So the ability to only take 19 or so players and long travel, altitude, playing in potential high heat and less humidity, all can weigh a factor. So we've got to grow a lot between now and then.
It'll be an interesting, fun trip. It'll really test our focus and our mentality, having to turn around 24 hours later and play another tough game.